on the Chuckles, the letter N, and Laugh Show. That's up on YouTube. Check us out. We're getting ready to flood that thing with some older, new footage, if that makes sense for you guys. And we are talking all things evil clowns, because this is the year of the evil clown. Not the year of the clown, because that's lame. This is the year of the evil clown, Chuckles the Clown. I don't care about the rest of you clowns out there.
All right, that was going to be the thought that crossed my mind, though, is, you know, speaking of all things evil clowns, are there any, you know, everybody has influences, everybody has roots. Are there any, whether it's actual clowns, is it, you know, or some diabolical harlequin creature from, you know, do you have any inspirations?
Now, if I told you my inspirations in my native tongue, none of you would understand it, because my first years are way before your human ears can comprehend. It's back in the Renaissance era. So I bring up those names, you guys would go, huh? But to go into a modern, more recent times, two clowns that I have modeled myself after, and we'll get to a third problem in a little bit. Not a problem, but an upraising. But the first two, number one, of course, if you ever see the way I dress in person, be the Joker. And the second one, if you listen to my humor or see any bit of my face paint, would be Sid Haig's Captain Spaulding from House of a Thousand Corpses, my favorite horror movie. Those are the two inspirations. A lot of people see my paint and they right away, and I'm not going to bash people, because that's not what I want to do, because I want to have listeners. And these guys, they pay for me. Their money's green. So when they hire me for a show, I show up.
He just bashes the non-listeners.
But yeah, I am in no shape or way a juggalo. And I don't like being referred to that. Do I enjoy the music? Yes, it is funny. Do I enjoy the company of some of the folks that are in there? Yes, a small portion of them. But there is, that small portion has gotten smaller because the dumb portion has gotten larger. Just by reading the news, you see stuff happening, people holding up banks with scissors that are juggalos. I mean, come on, really? A scissor? Yeah, I mean, what are you going to do with that? The guy's got guns. Cutting off people's heads for not liking their music? Who the hell does that shit? I mean, it's really, it's anti, like, it's not helping your cause out at all. And once they labeled them as a gang, I really had to distance myself. I've already got problems. I don't want to be getting labeled as being part of a gang. That would be two strikes. I'm definitely out, and I will no longer be in the happy insane asylum. I will be in the insane asylum attached to the ACI.
The Guantanamo Asylum.
Yeah, and I don't want to be attached to that one. But if you are into that sort of thing, awesome. And if you want to book me and you do those shows, awesome. Just remember, I like the money that is colored green and usually has the one and the only Benjamin Franklin. Not the only one that's not a president, but the one I like best, because Alexander Hamilton is only a 20, and I'm worth more than a 20. We're going into, you asked me what were my clown influences, and I gave you that. And I went into the bad stuff there. But when you sit back and you think clowns in comics, the first one that comes to name is the biggest badass of all, the Joker. I mean, this guy in every book takes a vicious beating from Batman. And yet he is one of the only people to come so close and so maniacally close to killing Superman and the whole Justice League. Why? Because Batman foolishly stored everybody's weaknesses inside of the computer, thinking that the Joker is not smart enough to hack into that and get that stuff. The guy is sickly intelligent. Of course he would find a way.
Unless maybe Batman, who doesn't always think too highly of Superman, you know, maybe, you know, had a subconscious desire for the Joker to unearth Super, you know. Maybe there's more to this.
Maybe he made it so easy to the fact where the Joker could get it, or maybe the fact is Joker is really smart. I mean, you think of some of those tools he comes up with and some of the capers he pulls, and it takes a genius to pull that off. They say a genius and an insane man is one and the same. maybe a couple points off here and there. My favorite Joker, and a lot of people out there are saying, well, Heath Ledger, he did good. Yeah. And then the next person, of course, from the original, you know,
Cesar Romero. That is my pick.
Yeah, he's really good. But I got to go with Mark Hamilton because his voice, and it's a lot of people are sent back going, what? Why not Jack Nicholson? And that was a great Joker. But it's a lot harder to bring someone into enjoying a character just by using your voice. He had no body features to show you. It was just acting with his voice. And his voice is what brought that cartoon character to life, right, to the point where the cartoon and even the video games, now people hear that. And that is the voice of the Joker, probably because it was played the most. And that's one of my favorites. I was very sad to hear that after the last video game that came out, he retired as the voice to the Joker. So I was very sad to hear that. Is there anybody that I could see up and coming taking his place? There are a couple people. And one people are going to step back and they're going to smack themselves on the head and say, what? And you're going to say, wrestlers don't make good actors.
Usually.
But this man would pull this off really well. And when I was watching TNA, yes, I did unfortunately watch that when it was good. Sorry, Maniac Mike. TNA is horrible.
They have some good talent, though. They just misuse the talent.
It's just, it's horrible. It used to be really good, and I know
they don't think it was ever really, really good.
Oh, it was when it was a six-sided ring. It was really good. And then when they went back to the four-sided, it lost it, and then they jumped back, and it's too little, too late.
Well, put it this way. When they added Eric Bischoff and Hulk Hogan.
Yeah.
And let's just say it like it is. Those are the plague against wrestling.
I'm a Hogan fan, but those two clowns definitely... Yeah. They didn't help it out. I'm sorry, Hogan.
Yeah, Hogan has a wrestler, yes. But we're talking about as a behind-the-scenes figure here. Let's make that clear.
Right. And I don't think it's so much Hogan as it was Bischoff and some of the writers that were there that ruined that. Hogan's just a spokesman that was going out doing what he was told. I'm sure he had money behind it. But this guy would make a really good Joker. And you're going to say, what? Sting.
Go ahead.
If you caught him, he was slightly impersonating, not slightly, really was impersonating him in TNA.
Yeah.
He had that character down locked, right down to the craziness. And the makeup wasn't perfect when he was putting it on.
I think he did that for real. I mean, copyright issues.
Right. But even the Joker, everybody thinks of him always being all pretty and all painted up, but there's times when his makeup is not. It's all a mess because he's a mess. Perfect character. Anybody you think would pull it off? I mean.
I wouldn't recommend doing it now because of his other acting roles, but Loki from... The Avengers and the Thor movies.
I didn't even think of that.
That actor, I'm ashamed of myself because I don't remember. His name slips my mind. But he, I think, would do a respectable job. Obviously, he wouldn't want to do it now, but either him, nobody else offhand. It's a difficult thing to do right.
Who do you guys think? Let us know. Let us know who you think would make a good Joker. Put it up there. Put it on my Facebook page, Albert H. Berger. Or put it up on thechucklesandlaughs.com. Or even visit RhodeIslandFreeRadio.org and put it in a comment. Who do you think would make a good Joker? And we'll come back and talk more about clowns, but we're going to go down to this Steve Miller Band, The Joker, here on Chuckles Crypt, Rhode Island Free Radio.
Some people call me the space cowboy. Yeah. Some call me the gangster of love. Some people call me Maurice. 'Cause I speak of the pompousness of love. People talk about me, baby. Say I'm doing you wrong, doing you wrong. I'm a grinner, I'm a lover, and I'm a sinner. music in the sun. I'm a joker, I'm a smoker, I'm a midnight toker. I get my loving on the run.
Love that song. Steve Miller Band, really good. If you ever get a chance to catch them live, you will not regret it, especially if you were a stoner. Everything your wish comes true with
no,
that
no, you
one.
Don't, you don't have to be a stoner. I went to see him live a few years back, and it was impressive.
And you will be a stoner even if you're not, especially when that song goes up and that big green cloud hits there. You're a stoner, whether you like it or not. He is incredible, Steve Miller, and I'm actually happy that the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame he is bound for that. Good to see that some guy that puts out not one, not two, not three, but four or five good albums where the whole every song on it is listenable.
Well, that's the thing when you go see him is, you know, he plays all these songs, top 10 hits, number one hits, and then you say to yourself, okay, well, about three quarters of the way through the show, what has he got left to play for encores? And then guess what? He just keeps playing. He yep. just keeps going. And it's like, oh, yeah, this one. Oh, yeah.
I have a greatest hit album of his, Steve Miller's Greatest Hits. And it was one of the very few gifts that Deadly Dan gave me so I wouldn't throw him down the elevator shaft. I appreciated it, but there are 25 greatest hit songs on that. Can you name an artist off the top of your head that can give you 25 greatest hits on one CD?
And they're all big hits.
They're all
that's the
difference.
I mean,
large.
Yeah. There's plenty of artists that have put out greatest hits, and there's basically three great hits and then garbage.
Right. But, right.
Yeah. You know, no, these are legitimate top 10 hits.
Now we're talking all things clowns, so I had to put that song up there, "The Joker," and you are listening to Chuckles Crypt here on Rhode Island Free Radio. And of course, if you want to listen to this over again, you can go on RhodeIslandFreeRadio.org. And re-listen to it, click onto it, and pull it up. When we talk clowns, everybody goes into the Joker. Now, there are other clown characters that do exist in the comic world, but are they worth mentioning? I mean, is Clown Q from Spider-Man worth my time?
No.
No, that is horrible. Anything from Spider-Man, with the exception of Venom and Carnage, is not worth my time. And it must be rated R Carnage. None of that PG-13 stuff that Disney's going to give us now. Trust me, fans, they are going to water that down, and you're not going to enjoy that. And I see it happening. And I know everybody says they don't ruin things, but you're going to ruin Carnage because